Karina Graham. I'm one of the owners and directors at Veterinary Specialists of Sydney, and I've got Laurencia Brunel, who's our soft tissue surgeon, expert in cardiac surgery. And we're really excited today because we've got a couple of cases that are having a procedure called transapical edge-to-edge repair of their mitral valve. So these little dogs have a leak through their heart valve, which is devastating. Often these dogs don't live even up to a year after we diagnose them. And so popping a little clip on their valve to try and stop the leak is what we're trying to do. We call it minimally invasive, but it does have a little mini surgery, which Dr. Brunel does.
Compared to the open heart surgery, it's a much smaller opening through the chest. So obviously the recovery and pain associated with the procedure is smoother. The MitraClip is only indicated on some selected cases. Unfortunately, it cannot be offered to all dogs who have like mitral valve disease. But when the dog is a candidate for a MitraClip, they don't need to go on the bypass and they can have this minimally invasive procedure.
Yeah, so the nice part is we also do mitral valve open repair here too. Dr. Laurenzi runs that service, but this is for particular cases that fit into a certain candidacy and the dogs recover beautifully. So I also wanted to acknowledge that we've got Hongyu Medical here. So they've actually sent over two of their engineers, which are experts in this device. It's called a V-clamp, which is similar to the MitraClip. And so they're actually heavily involved, and we've also, luckily enough, we've got a human interventional cardiologist here as well, Professor Muller. So we couldn't have a better team, which is amazing. We've got Chloe undergoing a procedure this morning. So she's had her transesophageal echo, which is an ultrasound image of her heart that you can have a look at. And so we're just about to start the procedure in her, and fingers and toes crossed she does just as well. So we've finished with little Chloe. She's had her V-clamp placed into the mitral valve. It was a success, which is terrific. She's still in recovery. We've got team anaesthesia, Ines and Chris, that did a terrific job. Her anaesthetic was beautiful. And Mariko just doing some post-operative images of her echo, her ultrasound. And you can see on the screen here, this is what the clamp looks like before we deploy it. So that's into the heart directly. And then after, that's what the clip looks like. So that clip will stay in her and hopefully keep her mitral leak at bay so she can go on and live a nice full life. So we were very lucky also to have Sharon Kay, who is a cardiac physiologist, assess the toe, the transesophageal ultrasound, as well as Mateo and a full team of nursing staff. So, you know, we're really happy with the result and hopefully she recovers well.
So today Chloe had the TEER procedure. Everything went successful, which we're extremely grateful for. The past few weeks have been quite hard on us with her going back into congestive heart failure. For the reasoning why we wanted to do the procedure was that it was going to benefit her quality of life, such as us taking her on walks again, being able to take her to the beach rather than her being on restricted exercise all the time. But yeah, we're feeling great that she's in recovery and looking good.